subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with India, which has eased restrictions after around 2 months of a strict lockdown. The decision has been taken in the line of steps being taken by the government of India to restore economic normalcy. While the glitter of markets is slowly returning, the aviation sector is set to resume its operations domestically. Meanwhile, the country has also equipped itself with tech and equipments to conduct more testing.
The diamond industry and gold showrooms reopened in India's western Gujarat state as the government gave relaxations in the fourth phase of coronavirus lockdown. With the government allowing 50% of the factories to reopen in Surat, the world's largest diamond polishing hub, Diamond Tears returned to work. However, in the absence of workers who have returned to their homes due to the lockdown, the industry would take time to get back to its normal functioning.
रूपाणी सरकार ने डायमंड इंडस्ट्री में 50% फैक्ट्री चालू करने का और ऑफिस में 33% स्टाफ के साथ जो चालू करने का किया है वो बहुत अच्छा निर्णय लिया है. लेकिन एक तरफ से देखा जाए तो सूरत में डायमंड इंडस्ट्री में कारीगर जो रत्नकला का लोग हैं बहुत लोग जुड़े हुए हैं और उन लोग अपने वतन में चले गए हैं. करीबन 50 से 60% लोग वतन में अभी जा चुके हैं.
Gold showrooms that reopened in Western Rajkot city said they would ask customers to follow social distancing and sanitize themselves to prevent the spread of the pandemic. Just like the diamond industry, the airports too are prepared to welcome the passengers again. Under a similar system of fare pricing, the flights are set to operate from 25th of May. A host of preventive measures have been taken by the airports to keep corona at bay. Guidelines have been issued for the passengers too. It includes mandatory social distancing at airports, revisions in the way security procedures are conducted to ensure minimal contact, use of face masks, and personal protective equipment by passengers and employees.
Well, I'm very happy that we finally have announced the decision that flights will commence from Monday, the 25th of May, in a calibrated manner, and that these flights will go to all parts of the country. Initially, only a small percentage of the total number of flights, but depends on the kind of experience we gain, we will increase the number of flights.
After incurring losses worth trillions in past 2 months, the government has laid out a plan to revive the country's economy. Several companies across sectors, ranging from textiles to consumer electronics and liquor to pharma, have partially resumed operations after getting permission from local authorities. And all this is being done keeping in mind the health of people. While the testing has gone significantly up, new and exclusive COVID-19 hospitals are being set up. The country has achieved its target of doing 1 lakh tests much before its own deadlines of May end. States have united in providing relief and isolation to the people who are stranded or were not able to follow the measures in the COVID-19 atmosphere.
Moving on to Afghanistan, where after months of dispute and deliberation, former Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah, who had earlier announced to run a parallel government, has joined hands with President Ashraf Ghani. He'll now be the part of the government with a few cabinet seats being given to his team. Now, the alliance, which appears to have both agenda and strategy, is being seen with optimism. While one faction will deal with the Taliban and the peace process, the other will deal with country's administration and the pandemic. A report.
Ending the months-long political stalemate, a power-sharing deal between the President Ashraf Ghani and his rival and former Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah has been signed. Although the deal was not formed on the lines of 2014 power-sharing formula, it has seemingly been signed keeping the national interest in mind. The two major takeaways of the alliance include Abdullah leading the Council for Peace talks with the insurgent Taliban and his team members getting inclusion in the cabinet. Although the portfolio has not been decided, the Abdullah camp is assured of getting 50% share in the cabinet. President Ashraf Ghani, who was not included in the peace talks between the Taliban and the United States, hailed the decision, saying the two camps had united just for the sake of the country.
امروز برای افغانستان عزیز ما روز مهم تاریخی است. افغان‌ها ثابت ساختند که با تدبیر، عقل جمعی، با منافع ملیشان می‌اندیشند و با آن متحدند. ما نشان دادیم که بدون میانجیگری دوستان بین‌المللی می‌توانیم به طریقه معقول به راه‌حل اساسی برسیم. در افغانستان دی ملی مصالحه د عالی شورا رئیس محترم دکتر صب عبدالله عبدالله څخه مننه کوم چې د هیواد ملي ګټو ته یې خپل ژمنتیا او تعود ثابت کړل او دغه لوی مسؤلیت یې ومنه.
Ashraf Ghani and Abdullah Abdullah, both of them being the most influential people in the war-torn country, are political rivals since 2014 presidential elections. Just like these elections, in the previous elections too, both of them fought a tough contest and a subsequent war of allegations had followed. Abdullah Abdullah had remained defiant post these elections and had even threatened to run a parallel government. Abdullah said he took the decision after realizing that country's stability was the need of the hour.
و طبعا در فضایی که بود توافق سیاسی هم کار آسان نبود چون نظرات بسیار متفاوت بود اما با یاری خداوند بزرگ به خاطر رضای خدا و منافع اولیای کشور یک قدم بزرگ برداشته شد بی ثباتی به نفع افغانستان نبود میتونست افغانستان به قهقرا ببره
The news has also given a shot in the arm to the US and NATO, who have its troops stationed in the region. NATO, which maintains a training camp in Afghanistan, hailed the deal and urged Afghan leaders and the Taliban to work for peace. The US was frustrated by the growing impasse between the two men, even after Secretary of State Mike Pompeo traveled to Kabul in March to mediate. It had announced it planned to cut $1 billion in aid because the men could not agree. It was not immediately clear whether Sunday's agreement would result in the aid commitment being reinstated.
Moving on to India, where each single organization and individual is playing its role in country's fight against the pandemic, be it the central government, local administrations, or the common masses, everyone is working together, shoulder to shoulder, to combat the virus. where the government is leaving no stone unturned in its efforts to support both the citizens and the economy, which has been battered by a weeks-long lockdown. The local administrations, too, are taking every single step to prevent the virus from spreading. A number of good Samaritans are also trying to bring cheers to people who are worst affected by the coronavirus lockdown. We have a report.
The government of India has come to the rescue of country's economy that has been battered by coronavirus triggered 2-month lockdown. It plans to provide as many as $27 billion to set up an agriculture infrastructure fund for the farmers. The state-run National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, that is NABARD, will raise funds to set up the new scheme, as per the Finance Ministry officials. The allocation is a part of $267 billion fiscal and monetary package to support the economy, which has been battered by a weeks-long lockdown to curb the spread of COVID-19. The government is also looking forward to amend the 6.5-decade-old Essential Commodities Act to ease restrictions on the trade of farm products.
We shall bring a central law so that farmers will be able to have the choice to sell his produce at an attractive price. He has no barriers in interstate trade. So though interstate trade at the moment is restricted, it should be barrier-free. We also want to make sure there is a framework for him to have his produce e-traded.
Earlier, with an aim to help 4.5 million businesses by October 2020, the government came up with a plan to provide a credit guarantee to businesses to avail collateral-free loans from banks. The attack and effect of virus has been multi-layered. It is not just the economy, but almost all sections of public lives have been hit hard. So it's not just the federal government, but the states and the local administrations too have been dutifully protecting the citizens. One such example is in Ludhiana district of Punjab, where the administration has roped in hotels to quarantine its citizens coming back from foreign countries amid coronavirus pandemic. All those returning from foreign countries are being medically screened at the airports, while those with symptoms are treated as per medical advice. Asymptomatic people are asked to self-quarantine at hotels. Hotels are given special set of guidelines to manage sanitization for the duration of quarantine of the returning citizens.
लगभग हमारे पास 20 होटल्स ने रजिस्टर किया है जिसमें हमारे पास 800 कमरे अभी रेडी हो चुके हैं इसके सिवाय हमारे पास जो अपनी खुद की सरकारी फैसिलिटी है उसमें लगभग 150 से ऊपर रूम्स हैं और ट्रैवलर के पास ऑप्शंस हैं दोनों ऑप्शंस हम उसे देते हैं कि वो सरकारी फैसिलिटी में जाना चाहता है या प्राइवेट होटल में जाना चाहता है
A number of good Samaritans from across the country are also contributing their bit in this time of pandemic. In New Delhi, a 34-year-old counselor, Sheetal Agarwal, and her sisters are bringing cheers to the migrant workers staying in the city's shelters by dressing up themselves as clowns. During a recent visit to a shelter housing hundreds of workers, she and her sister danced in a hula hoop and joked around with families and police officers.
We are going to shelter home where there are a lot of migrants staying right now because of the lockdown who could not go back to their places, and they are confined to these closed spaces where they are placed. So we are going to cheer them up because we feel that if staying at home we can be so unhappy or so sad and stressed, then their level of stress would be very high considering they are not even with their families or they really are worried about the families back home. So we thought it will be wonderful if we can bring a smile on their faces and distract them from the pain that they are feeling.
The collective efforts of the government and citizens have definitely paid off and have so far given positive results. Recently, while addressing the 73rd World Health Assembly by video conferencing, Union Health Minister Harshvardhan was also set to take charge as WHO Executive Board Chairman at its 147th session, asserted that the country has done well in dealing with the disease till now and is confident of doing better in months to come. Though there can be spike in the number of corona positive cases in India, but due to advanced planning and swift actions of the Indian government, the country has been managing the coronavirus crisis much better than many other countries.
Moving on to the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan, where the residents are suffering unreasonable restrictions of the pandemic. The knee-jerk reaction of the administration to seal borders of a district after the cases spiked suddenly has created huge troubles for the locals. They are neither being allowed to go to the hospitals nor to their offices. People call it nothing short of a detention.
An unannounced administrative order of sealing district borders of Gilgit town in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan has caused massive inconvenience to the people. Hundreds of vehicles are stranded at district border after they have been denied entry. The corps say that the measures have been taken in light of preventive steps being taken by authorities to stem the spread of coronavirus. However, the locals who are stuck in an atmosphere similar to that of police detention say the measures were announced impromptu to trouble the people of the region.
Sultanabad check post pe hame roka ja raha hai, hum district Niger se aaye hue hain, to hamare mareez check karane aaye hain, to yahan hamare liye pareshani ka baais hai, to government ke writ ka hum ehtram karte hain, aisi baat nahi hai, yahan ka district magistrate agar koi order karta hai तो फिर एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट हमारे पास भी है, डिस्ट्रिक्ट नगर, फिर वहाँ हमें भी बंद करना होगा, फिर हंगामी हालत सूरत पैदा होगी जो इस खत्ते के लिए अच्छा शगुन नहीं है।
While there was no prior notice issued to curb the travel, an instant barricading and not considering even the urgency of the travel has left people frustrated and in pain. There are a few who need immediate medical attention, but police is not letting them go, citing they have received such orders from higher authorities.
ये मेरी बच्ची है, मैं उधर से आया हूँ। सात दिन मैं इधर हॉस्पिटल में रहा, डीएचक्यू में भी और जीएमसी में। अभी मुझे कह रहे हैं कि आप गाड़ी वापस करके वापस अपने डिस्ट्रिक्ट जाओ, और खुद मैं डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में
Even those employed in Gilgit town are not allowed any movement. People are unable to comprehend the exercise and they don't know when they will be relieved.
हम सुल्तानाबाद गए थे, अभी वापस जा रहे, तो कह रहे आपके स्नैच कार्ड होंगे, काम आपको नहीं छोड़ सकते। ड्यूटी मेरी इधर ही है, मैं रहता हूँ इस्कंदास में, ड्यूटी मेरी गिलगित में।
Although the authorities have been dismissive of the fact that the numbers of COVID-19 patients are growing exponentially in the region, but there could not be any reasonable rationale apart from this behind these sudden harsh measures. The government of Pakistan, which claims the region to be its part, has ignored the region completely since the outbreak of the virus. The region does not have enough testing labs, medical equipments or hospitals. It does not even have any monitoring agency that can tell the real number of fatalities. As per the government of Pakistan, the region has reported 550 cases, but the toll could be many times higher in reality.
Moving on. While the world economy and the purchasing power of almost all individuals on the planet have been hit by the pandemic, an unusual spike in the consumption of the Ceylon black tea or Sri Lankan black tea has been observed lately. Such is the case that exporters are finding it hard to meet the global demands for this beverage, which according to Tea Board Laboratory of the country is an effective treatment against the coronavirus. The market is overwhelmed with orders and the prices are rising at fast pace. A report.
The coronavirus has triggered a record spike in the prices of Sri Lankan tea, which is known for its immunity boosting properties. Has surged in the wake of various scientific papers and experts suggesting that black tea proves to be a potent weapon against the virus with no side effects. The export price for a kilogram of tea has increased from an average of around $2 to around $7 at the Colombo tea auction. A particular low-grown tea was sold at an all-time record price of $13.84 per kilogram.
Lokawel na pole illuma kuttawa eth ekkama ape me avasthave anith ratawal wala nishpadaniya saha ounge videsha ratawal walata te yawima nather wi sitna nisa e patthenut apita yam kisi වාසියක් ලැබුණයි කියලා කියන්න පුළුවන්. ඒත් එක්කම අපිට සැලකිය යුතු මට්ටමේ මිලක් අපිට ලැබුණා අපේ තේ වලට.
The scientists at the Sri Lanka Tea Board Laboratory suggest that frequent consumption of hot black tea is capable of flushing viruses trapped in the throat area. This practice is believed to improve immune capability and inhibit inflammation due to catechins and polyphenols contained in black tea. Further, inhaling the fumes of the black tea at high temperature facilitates the removal of virus trapped around the nasal area and open the pathway for the tea thiavalins to reach the lungs and protect it from viruses.
ඒක හුඟාක් දුරට වැඩිවීමේ වර්ධනයක් අපි දැක්කා ඒක මේ තේ වෙන්දේසියේ නීලු ඉන්න ප්‍රවීණයන්වත් මං හිතන්නේ අපේක්ෂා කරපු විදියට වඩා වැඩිවීමක් දක්නට ලැබුණා.
Tea production in Sri Lanka was down nearly a quarter due to an earlier drought and coronavirus affecting production and the supply line in March. But the production and supplier bottleneck got resolved in April. The prices of raw tea leaves too have shot up, giving a major boost to small-scale growers who produce 75% of island nation's tea. Authorities say they are working on the process of making the system more organized so that everybody is satisfied with the prices.
අපේ ප්‍රමිතිය රැකගෙන ඉදිරියට ගියොත් මං හිතන්නේ අපිට තවදුරටත් මේ ඊටාම ඉහළ මිලක් කෙසේ වෙතත් සම්පූර්ණ ආදායම සහ විදේශ විනිමය වැඩි කර ගැනීමේ ක්‍රියාදාමයකට සැලසුම් සකස් කරලා මේ පුද්ගලික අංශය රාජ්‍ය අංශයත් සමග ඒකාබද්ධව වැඩපිළිවෙලක් සකස් කරලා ඒක ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙමින් පවතිනවා.
The stifled supplies come just as the global demand for food and beverages has risen with the epidemic confining people indoors. Also, the world's most consumed drink after water is emerging as the preferred choice for many due to low caffeine content and other health benefits.
Ceylon tea business is one of the handfuls of businesses that didn't receive a dent but profited hugely. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.